Good day, global crypto enthusiasts. This is 88 Fantastic coming to you Tuesday, August 13th, 2019. What's up, y'all? Thank you for taking your time out of your busy day to come and visit me for a few minutes on the channel. Again, another ugly day in the market. It's just been absolutely disgusting for the last week. We've seen no new money coming into this market. And right now, we see a little bit of panic sell-off in the last 24 hours. As again, there's been nothing new coming into this market. And the buggers that take all their profit out every month, they ain't putting anything back in. So up in our corner, we see a live price of Bitcoin at 10,919, day low of 10,800 and a day high of 11.5. That was way last night. And as you can see, what Bitcoin's been doing here in the last few hours, it's been absolutely kind of gross. So we're going to have a look at our actual market cap here as we're sitting at 286 billion. And this is our last couple of months here. As you can see, we've been constantly hemorrhaging and sliding backwards. The market is absolutely getting no love whatsoever right now. So we'll just have a quick look at our market. Market cap sitting at 286.4 billion, trading volume of almost 50 billion. Let's have a look over our last 7 days here, and this is more than likely going to be red all across the board. We'll try and find somebody that's actually had some movement, but I highly doubt anything's had any movement over the last 7 days. So let's just have a quick peek, and we're just going to scan right through this. We'll go right through the top 100 today. We'll see what we got. We got three very interesting articles for you guys today. And let's have a looky here. Like, just nothing. Last video we did, there was only, four coins or five coins in the top 50 that actually had more than 1% over the last 7 days. Let's do it that way. So in the last 7 days, Bitcoin Cash at 1%. Binance Coin, 6.3%. 6.36%. Now we scroll all the way down to 28th. V Systems at 1.3%. Huobi token at 4%. Come on, where are we? Educare at 12.5%. We'll keep going. We'll do the top 100. That's about 5. Bitcoin at 6. Mixin at 7.92%. Oh, what do we got there? Made Safecoin at 2%. Oh my God. Next at 12%. Wax at 5%. So we got maybe 10 total coins in the top 100 that have seen more than 1% while the rest of the market continually bleeds out. The one thing we wanted to check to see when Bitcoin starts to slide back, we wanted to see if Ethereum's trading volume was going to increase, and it hasn't. About a week and a half ago, Ethereum was trading at about 7.5 billion. Last video 2 days ago, it was trading at 6.5 billion. Now we see the volume of ETH in 24 hours averaging at 5.8. That is just not good for everybody. Let's see what every other volume is doing here. This is usually a pretty good indicator when my computer is working with us here. You know what? We'll just go back over here, go to our market, and that's all we want to check is our 24-hour volume. Tether at 16, Bitcoin at 16, and that is it. Tether, that's about a normal 24-hour, but for Bitcoin at 16 right now, I'm assuming it's just more or less a lot of pressure selling right now. And again, people are just not having very much faith in crypto and Bitcoin itself right now, which is absolutely ridiculous. As we all know, I'm still a firm believer. Smart money is just continuing to punish everybody, and the wealthy guys behind the scenes, they're just getting in as cheap as they possibly can, and they're getting ready for the rest of this year as well. So let's get out of here, and let's go have a look at some of these articles. We got some pretty cool stuff for you guys today. Let's go backwards today. First article is over at coindesk.com. The SEC guidance gives ammo to lawsuit claiming XRP is unregistered security. So again, for me, I've always said myself, I'm actually a fan of the Ripple company itself, but the XRP cryptocurrency is fucking garbage. It has zero use casage, and when a company like Ripple creates its own cryptocurrency and two or three people in the Ripple company own 90% of that, all they did was print themselves free money and basically said to the rest of the world, here's 10% of our supply, go have at it. So the article goes on as the takeaway, a new amended complaint against Ripple draws on the SEC's framework for digital assets to outline how XRP might be a security, likely the first federal case to do so. The filing also cites California advertising law in addition to federal security laws to argue that investors were misled by Ripple's promotion of XRP. While the case is a year old and has not received class action status, the new complaint is the first that Ripple must respond to with a substantive answer. Ripple has until the middle of September to file its response. Okay, if you're an XRP holder, I'm going to let you come in and read this article because, like I said, a million times on my channel, I'm a fan of Ripple, but I do not like the XRP currency. It, for me, it has absolutely, unless you're going to use it for fucking tipping. I mean, we can use every crypto in the world to tip, but if that's your best case usage, I mean, I don't think banks need any more data spreadsheets than what Ripple's already going to give these guys. So we'll leave that one up for you guys. That's over at Coindesk.com. Second article is, again, over at Coindesk.com. SEC delays decisions on three Bitcoin ETF proposals. This one really hurt, and I'm assuming a lot of people were banking on this to come and happen. But again, with the ETFs, the SEC just keeps hammering these things, and they're just not allowing anything to come out. So we'll go through some of this article for you guys. The ETFs proposed earlier this year by assets manager Bitwise Asset Management, the VanEck SolidX, and the Wilshire Phoenix, and filed with exchanges, New York Stock Exchange, CBO, are all seeking to become the first such investment vehicle based on Bitcoin. The filings were published in the Federal Register in February and June, kicking off the legally mandated 240-day clock on the final decision. The next decisions will be coming on October 13th and 18th, as well as September the 29th. While a number of companies have proposed Bitcoin ETFs in recent years, the regulatory agency has yet to approve any, citing concerns with market manipulation, market surveillance, and a potential divergence in with futures trading as some of the issues. To me, this is an absolute fucking joke that the SEC keeps denying all of these ETFs from already SEC registered complying companies. So again, it goes into, again, I hate to keep using the word crypto conspiracy theories, but it's just absolutely ridiculous when you've actually got legitimate open SEC compliant companies trying to get this product out to the rest of the world, and they just keep blocking it at every single place, right? Bitwise has sought to alleviate these concerns, publishing multiple reports indicating that the actual Bitcoin market is similar, more regulated, and much better surveilled than expected, and that it trades tightly with the CME futures market. So now you got CME has been in this since October of 2018. They're the largest on the planet, and yet we still can't get a Bitcoin ETF put out a SEC. So again, for me, that's absolutely disgusting. I still think it's, like I've always said, it's the backdoor politician officials, the Wall Street bankers, and all of the gobbledygook in the American banking and political system that is just continuing to stymie it because they're buying as much as they can and they want it as cheap as they can because they know what you and me know, that at some point, Bitcoin is going to be the ultimate currency throughout the whole. I'm not saying it's going to be the global currency, but it's definitely, along with actual physical gold, going to be the two mainstays for safekeeping, right? So here's my favorite article, and we saved this one for last over at Cointelegraph.com. American boxing legend Iron Mike Tyson chooses blockchain for a new adventure. Okay, so before anyone comes on and starts talking shit about Tyson and whatever they need to say, you got to understand the man's background on how he lost so much money from bad contracts and from bad promotion and from being surrounded by people that just ripped him off his whole life. Now he wants to come out and show something. Same thing as when you're blockchaining your art and your music and things like that. This is very, very, very good. While Mike Tyson will serve as the founder and chairman of the Sports and Competition Committee for Fight to Fame, the project also counts, we'll let that, you figure out that guy's name, as its CEO, the two-time Emmy Award winner, Tim Smythe, as its television producer, and Stan Larimer as its cryptocurrency and blockchain expert. Tyson says in a statement, "As a seasoned fighter, I want to mentor future generations." Oh, I'm starting to talk like him too now with no teeth. "Especially future action stars, and make sure there's a path to career success and fair compensation." That is the main thing he's doing, fair compensation. And again, if you've ever seen a biography of Mike Tyson, you see how much money Don King actually ripped this man off for, how much Don King ripped off Larry Holmes for. It's absolutely sickening. And again, I always believe that these are the things that are still holding us back because it's open source, open ledger, open to the public. And that's why the American bankers and the American politicians are still holding this back as long as possible. This is about wealth generation from the masses, but back to the masses through all the participants and stakeholders. So it's not just a win-win. This is multiple wins for all stakeholders. A fan token economy will be launched in order to drive engagement as well as to reap the project's gains for the fighters, fans, and companies alike. This is very cool, and I really like stuff like this. It's about time we start seeing more popular people come out and share the news with this. I've seen some things on Kevin O'Leary. If you guys aren't for sure, he's the guy on Shark Tank, the guy that always looks like a dick. And he's always out there telling people how shitty Bitcoin is. And this is in the last, from present day and go back 2 years. And Kevin O'Leary keeps talking about how shitty Bitcoin and cryptocurrency all it is. I watched a video yesterday from CBC Canada from 2013 where Kevin O'Leary is on TV telling all of Canada and the rest of the world that 3% of his portfolio it was actually Bitcoin in 2013, but yet in 2019, he still plays dumb, acts stupid, doesn't know what anything is. Again, with smart money, you don't listen to what they're saying, you do what they're doing. Plain and simple, and that's what we've always said in this market. So, well, one more quick look at the cryptocurrency market, and then we're going to get out of here. Keep it nice and short and sweet for you guys. Again, sitting at 286, still looking like we're going to slide back. And you know what? Like I've always said, just got to hang in there, people. Don't panic sell. If you can, wait till the pump and dump groups get to your coin. Try and generate some income. Get it out of there. And right now, like we've always said, the only two trustworthy projects on this planet right now, and in this entire market, As much as I hate to say it, it's still just Bitcoin and Ethereum. As much as I love something else, you know, we'll go down through the list here. I really enjoy the Binance coin. But again, that's one thing we wanted to talk about before I actually do get out of here is marketing. We've said for so long on this channel, and again, if you've never owned your own business, you have no idea what I'm talking about. It doesn't matter how good your tech is if you don't fucking market it. How is anybody on this planet going to know how good your project is if you do not market and advertise? So again, Bitcoin aside is the only one that does not fit into this category. Everybody else, when was the last time you seen EOS advertise on TV? When was the last time we seen Tron on TV or DA? Any of these people actually have a TV advertisement on your news page? The only ones I see online through doing my faucets and web searching is Nexo and Salt as lending platforms. I see nothing else anywhere going. Litecoin might be the only one that's actually done something in this entire space to help the cryptocurrency market, whereas everybody else thinks by fucking tweeting something and bitching in Telegram and jumping on Reddit, that is not going to bring money into this market, people. Advertising is what brings money and generates interest all across the board. So ain't got too much more. You know, we've got a few more weeks to wait. It's only August 13th right now. I'm not panicking whatsoever. Again, for me, it's not all about the price right now. For me, it's about the masses and introducing many more people into the space, and that's just not happening right now. And we've seen that basically from the middle of July right till now. And if these companies, you know, when you go into Telegram, you're like, hey, when are you going to start getting this going? Well, we're more focused on our tech. You know what? If you keep focusing on your tech, you're not even going to have a company in a couple of weeks. How are you going to keep surviving when your project is 95% in the hole from where it was in 2017 and 18? You're not going to be able to survive. And we're going to start to see a lot more of these projects just disappear right off the map. Probably start to see a few more exchanges with some exit scams here in the upcoming weeks. So again, you got to be safe. Be diligent. Do your research. Be comfortable. That's the best thing I can possibly say to anybody. When you come into this space, you need to be comfortable with the decision that you make. You need to be skeptical as well. You can't be trusting a guy like me on YouTube. You can't be trusting anybody on YouTube or social media. Google is your best friend. Spend a few minutes, do some research, and be comfortable with the choice that you make moving forward. So anyways, ain't got too much more. We just wanted to come out and hammer some of these articles. Again, great to see Mike Tyson in there. Again, crypto conspiracy theory. Again, 1003 and 1004 with the SEC, the bankers, the shitty U.S. politicians. Again, I still believe they're still circling everybody up. And at some point, you're just going to get stuck buying a couple of little places. So we need the rest of the world to start applying some pressure. We need the cryptocurrency companies and projects and team leaders to actually get out there, open up your bloody war chest if you have anything left in there, and start fucking advertising, or you're going to get left behind. And at some point, we might only see a two-coin market in Bitcoin and Ethereum. There won't be a crypto... There won't be a coin market cap anymore. There won't be a coin gecko or a coin checkup. And all we're going to see is Bitcoin and Ethereum, and they're going to get thrown right into the regular puddle of mess in the regular stock market. We don't want that. We can't buy into that stuff. We need the crypto market to succeed. And in order to do that, people need to share and get new people into the space, and we need people investing. That's all there is to it. So anyways, that's all I got for you guys. Hope you have a great week. We'll come back in a day or two and check out and everything. This is 88 signing off. Take care, y'all.